tell yourself you can do it, and then tell others. Commit and figure out how. This is just so powerful for several reasons, but let me give you the punchline. If you're not reading these books this year, you are falling behind on your greatest potential. Yes, I know there are millions of books out there, many of which are phenomenal and can be life-changing. But of all of the books that I've read, these five that I want to share with you today have been incredibly impactful, and I have to share them with you. And by the way, maybe you've read some of them before. Maybe you've heard of some of them before. But what I want to do in this video right now is, number one, share the book with you to let you know that it's life-changing. But secondly, I'm going to share with you one quote or quick passage that really resonates with me strongly, and then share with you some thoughts on how I believe you can take the concept or idea into your own life to start becoming the best version of yourself, accelerating your success, and making this year your best year yet. So I'm really excited to dive in. And the very first book I want to share with you is Questions Are the Answer by Hal Gregersen. Hal is executive director of MIT Leadership Center. This book is phenomenal. As you can see here, I've got it tabbed up so many times. I've got all kinds of highlights in here. I'm an absolute fan of questions. If you're not yet a fan, I mean a raving fan of questions and mastering your ability to ask questions. Oh, just kick the camera. To ask questions, you must get this book. You will be convinced. By the end of this book, you will be convinced that questions can change your life. Questions are the lens through which you view the world. When we ask different questions, we see the world differently. So here's the passage from the book that I want to briefly share with you. Actually, I just want to share one line. It's this. The best, by the way, it's on page 21 of the book. The best questions, then, are the ones that excite the imagination and spur positive change. I'll read that one more time. The best questions, then, are the ones that excite the imagination and spur positive change. So when you ask a different kind of question, or you can craft a question that gets you excited about life, then you feel better. I mean, how often are you asking questions of yourself like, oh, why am I in this awful situation? Or, why do I feel that life's not going anywhere? Or why am I not making progress on my goals? Or gosh, why do I feel so down and low energy? It's those questions that hold you back because your brain starts to search for an answer. As soon as we ask any question, we start to look for answers. Our brain automatically, instantaneously starts to seek answers. And so first of all, what I'd hope you do is read this book to feel inspired and encouraged that questions can change your life. Being intentional with asking yourself the right questions can truly change your life. But number two, start asking yourself questions that really get you excited, that excite and inspire your imagination. Because it's the imagination, it's your imagination that can start to craft a vision of your future that's compelling, that gets you ready to take the action necessary to move forward on your dreams. If you today are not where you want to be, I would suggest to you, or I would guess, that it's probably because you don't have a compelling enough future vision. You don't have a vision of what life can be like. You know, if you look into the future of your life in your mind's eye and you don't see anything different than what you're experiencing today, if you think life's going to be more of the same, why would you be excited? You're not going to be. If you think life's just going to be the same over and over and over again, and every day you're going to wake up and it's going to be the same, and you're not going to be making progress, and you're not getting closer to an exciting, inspiring vision, then you're not going to put in the effort. You're not going to feel alive and vibrant. And the flame inside of you, that passion, that desire to become your best, is going to start to die down and dull. So if you can start to ask great questions of yourself, you can transform the way you see your future and see yourself differently so that you take action, feel fired up, motivated, and inspired to go towards that compelling vision. Book number two is actually by my friend Chris Connors, Chris D. Connors, Emotional Intelligence for the Modern Leader. This book truly has been a big time book on Amazon. You can go over there. I think there are several hundred, I should say, Amazon reviews. That's big time. You know, we might look at some of the major books, and I'm going to share a few with you here that are just big time authors that have sold millions and millions of copies. But to have a few hundred, several hundred reviews is incredible. And what that tells me is it's not just me who wants to talk about this book because Chris is my friend, but this book truly is impactful. And so what I want to share with you specifically from this book, and by the way, before I share the passage that I want to share, I want to mention that emotional intelligence is probably one of the most important topics or skills that you can study and develop this year. I mean, right now. It's such an important topic because most people think of intelligence as IQ, intellectual intelligence, and your ability to understand math and numbers and do schoolwork, whatever. But there are so many different kinds of intelligence, and our emotions are that invisible force that shape and mold our lives. And so if you're not taking command of your emotions, if you're not developing your emotional intelligence, your emotional regulation skills, then you're falling behind on your greatest potential. If you want to thrive in your relationships, you want to thrive in your career, you want to be a great parent, a great spouse, you want to be outstanding as an entrepreneur or business owner, you must learn to work on your emotional fitness, or what might be called your emotional intelligence. So here's the passage that I want to share with you. It's a little bit longer than the last one I shared, but bear with me because this absolutely is important for you to understand. So Chris says, I've developed 4 criteria to focus on as an emotionally intelligent leader to avoid obstacles that stand in the way of successfully leading your organization. Here's the passage. First, listen to this now. First, stop making excuses. God, there's more to this, but can we agree that excuses are nails in the house of failure? Every time you make an excuse, you're putting a nail in the house of building failure. And every time you don't make an excuse, you don't put that nail in and you stop building the house of failure and you'll start building the house of success. That's a quote from a football coach I had years ago that I loved. Excuses are nails in the house of failure. So first, stop making excuses. Acknowledge obstacles for what they are. This begins with what we tell ourselves. Acknowledge inherent biases for what they are. Address them and become a champion for changing things that stand in the way of you and your employees' success. Speak positively. Tell yourself you can do it. And then tell others. Commit and figure out how. This is just so powerful for several reasons, but let me give you the punchline in my mind of this paragraph. Speak positively to yourself. Tell yourself you can do it. So many of us are held back from going after our dreams, or held back from our greatest potential, or held back from being the best version of ourselves, because we don't tell ourselves that we can do it. We're hoping that somebody external to us is going to say, you know what? You can do it. I believe in you. I believe in your dreams. But that's not guaranteed to happen. I tell people all the time, and in many of the videos I make to encourage people like you who have big dreams and want to become the best version of themselves, I say that there's one person on this planet who is guaranteed to encourage you every single day. I'm sure you can guess at this point who that is. Yep. It's you. You are the only person who is guaranteed to encourage you every single day of your life. You might have the most amazing spouse in the world. I do. My wife is extraordinary, and she does encourage me pretty much every day. But I'm not guaranteed the encouragement of other people. I'm not guaranteed the positive, inspiring words from other people. I've got to say it to myself. I have to believe that I can do it. And you do too. And that's what emotional intelligence is all about. It's about no matter how you just innately feel in any given moment, you have to take command of your emotional state so that you can be your best self. Emotional intelligence is a vital skill to develop to be a leader, a great leader, and to be the best version of yourself and to make the success or the progress towards success that you truly want. By the way, I can tell you as a father of 2 kids under 2, my older child's about to turn 2 very soon here. But as a father of 2 under 2, not getting much sleep and having a lot of energy towards a lot of different things, it's easy to lose control of your emotions. Now, I wouldn't say I lose control of my emotions, but it's easy to get frustrated or irritated. And if we go down that path of frustration and irritation, we wire our nervous system to easily go there. But what we have to do is train ourselves that our path, the path that we go on more easily, is the path of joy and excitement and love and compassion and positivity. And if we can wire our brains, our nervous systems, and our bodies to biochemically desire to go down the path of that positive emotional state, that's what emotional intelligence is. That is emotional fitness. And that, my friend, can absolutely transform your life. Book number 3. Oh my gosh, this is a game changer. How to Break Free of the Drama Triangle and Victim Consciousness. And this is so huge. And the reason I can know for certain that this is a huge and important book is it's my most watched video. I made a video on this book, a brief 6-minute video a few years ago called How to Break Free from the Drama Triangle and Victim Consciousness. And it's got, at this point, over 16,000 views. And for some channels, that's small, but for me, that's massive. Over 16,000 people have watched this video. And what that tells me is many people find this topic extremely important. So I'd really encourage you to go just look at my most popular videos and you'll find that video. But the thing I want to share with you from this book specifically, in order to break free of victim consciousness, you must take charge of meeting your own needs. Here's the punchline. You must be willing to ask for what you want or need 100% of the time. It doesn't say you need to ask for what you want or need at least 50 to 60% of the time. You have to ask for what you want and need 100% of the time. Well, actually what it says, you must be willing to ask for what you want and need 100% of the time. And then it goes on to say, this doesn't mean that you will actually have to ask for everything you want to need, only that you are willing to do this. And here's one that I just highlighted in here that I want to highlight for you. You'll know that you have mastered being direct when you can ask for what you want in such a way that others are delighted to give it to you. I just listened to Phil M. Jones give a talk on YouTube about the power of asking and that we're only ever going to get what we want by asking for it. We can only get what we want by asking. That makes obvious, simple sense, but how often do you actually ask for the things that you want and need? And he made the point, which I believe fully, is that many people, not all of us, but many people in the world, they have that willingness or desire to ask questions beat out of them from an early age. And I don't mean physically beaten out of them. Some, unfortunately, that's the case. But I mean, just told over and over again, don't ask questions. Don't ask why. Just do what I say. And you stop asking for what you want and what you need, which goes back to the reason that the questions are the answer is the number one book I shared to start this video. Questions are powerful. Asking questions and asking for what you want and what you need is absolutely vital for creating the life that you want. I kicked the camera again. Why do I keep doing that? So I just want to invite you to go and grab this book. It is a game changer. It's 79 pages. It's short. It's quick. It's one of the most highlighted and underlined books that I have, that I own of all of them. And I think it can be truly a game changer for you. By the way, I'll link up all of these books below. This one that I'm about to share with you, book number 4, Atomic Habits by James Clear. You may have heard of it. You may have even read it. But I want to give you some perspective on something he talks about in this book that maybe you read it and it didn't necessarily click with you in the way that I'm about to share it with you. But this book has sold over, I think, like 4 or 5 million copies at this point in time. It's a simple yet powerful book. I've talked to so many people who have read this book, Atomic Habits, and they've said, oh my gosh, JJ, the ideas and concepts in that book are insanely simple. Like, I know them. They're so simple, but they're great reminders. As I say all the time, or I quote Samuel Johnson all the time, this phenomenal quote from an author from the 1700s, Samuel Johnson says, people need to be reminded more often than they need to be instructed. We need these simple reminders to transform our lives, to do the fundamentals consistently well over a period of time, to then accelerate our success and to create the results that we want. So here's the quick passage that I wanted to share with you from this book specifically. On page 190, James Clear says, the road less traveled is the road of delayed gratification. If you're willing to wait for the rewards, you'll face less competition and often get a bigger payoff. As the saying goes, the last mile is always the least crowded. Here's why this is vitally important. Here's why I chose to share that. I was recently thinking about my YouTube channel, and maybe you can relate to this in some other area of your life or some business venture or the career that you're in or wherever you're at in your life. I'm thinking about my YouTube channel, and you know, as I'm recording this, I've got about 255 subscribers, and I would love to reach even more people, thousands, hundreds of thousands, tens of thousands, millions, whatever it is that I'm going to have the opportunity to reach. But with 255 subscribers and getting just a handful of views on my videos, I just think to myself, what is the reward? 7 people watching my video. Now, granted, I'm so grateful that if a few people watch a video and it inspires them and encourages them and empowers them to go after their greatest potential and to become the best version of themselves, awesome. That's meaningful enough to me. But to me, a lot of making these videos is laying the foundation, the preparation, the skill development to get to where I want to be. I also just recently listened to Kurt Warner on Ed Milet's podcast because his movie came out called American Underdog. And in the interview with Ed Milet, Kurt Warner was talking about how he knew, he had this belief that he was meant to be an all-star NFL quarterback. He knew that he was an elite-level professional quarterback, but he did not yet have the opportunity. He said even when he was in the grocery store, stocking shelves before he had the opportunity to get called up into the NFL, when he was stocking shelves in a grocery store, he wanted to be the best that he could be. He wanted to give it everything he had, even if no one ever recognized it. He wanted to give it everything he had because he knew that that would set the tone for everything else he did in his life. And my friend, what I guess I'm trying to suggest to you here is if you can look into the future, if you can believe in a bigger, better, brighter future, and you can know that the work you're doing today is getting you where you want to go, even if you're not feeling the rewards, even if you're not feeling a tremendous amount of progress, and even if it feels like, gosh, I don't even know if I'm moving forward, if you can remind yourself that you're laying the foundation, doing the preparation work that's necessary to be where you want to be in a year or 2 years or 10 years or 20 years, that's what matters. Be very okay. Get comfortable, in fact, with delayed gratification, because if you put in the work today, you will reap the rewards next year or in 2 years or in 2 months. I don't know when it's going to happen, but I know for certain that if you're watching this, you want something more. You want better. You're trying to become the best version of yourself. And that concept of being great with delaying gratification and doing the work even when you're not getting the rewards, it will pay off at some point. And by the way, if you're trying to become the best version of yourself and achieve your biggest goals faster, that's actually exactly what my book is all about. This is not one of the five, but I wanted to mention it. I wrote this book, Attract Your Potential, because I truly want to take many of the concepts I've learned from not just these books, but dozens and dozens of others that I can believe, that I know can help you change your life, to feel inspired and excited and encouraged to go after your greatest potential. People have said, hey, I read this book and I feel motivated, I feel inspired, I'm looking at my confidence differently. So whether you're someone that just needs to develop your confidence or feel motivated or be encouraged, or you just need some simple shifts and strategies and tips and ideas to work on the fundamentals, to take yourself to your next level in life and or business, please go grab a copy of this. Again, I'll link it up in the description, just like I am with all of these books. And as I move on to this very last book, I got to tell you, this last one that I'm about to share with you is just one that I come back to over and over and over and over again. I review it. I look at the things I've highlighted. I reread chapters. It is a game changer. And it is Becoming Supernatural by Joe Dispenza. there's no cover on it. There is a cover on the hardback if you get it. But we spilled. I don't remember who. I'm not going to blame anybody. But water was spilled on the cover. So it no longer is working. Anyways, here's what I want to share with you from this book. It's so, like, look, just, are you kidding me? Look at all the highlights. Can you see that? I'm telling you, man, this book is a game changer. Here's what I want to share with you from this book. Listen to this now. It's important. He talks about doing a walking meditation. So there's a lot written on walking meditation before we get to what I'm about to read. But just know, a walking meditation basically is like a sitting meditation where you're envisioning your future self, but you're doing it while walking. And so he goes on to say, it's time to alter while you're walking. It's time to alter your stride, your pace, your posture, your breathing, your movements. You might smile instead of staring blankly. You may have to imagine what walking as a wealthy person feels like by modeling a wealthy person, which is a concept I actually talk about in my book, Attract Your Potential, as well, which is channel yourself into the energy of the person you want to become and do that long enough and with enough intensity and emotion, and you'll eventually become that person. But he says you might adopt the posture of a courageous person you admire. Walk within the elevated energy of your future healthy body, or walk as an open-hearted, loving, accepting person. Basically, you're consciously embodying the person you've always dreamed you could be, but walking as if your future self is imperative. Here's the message he's trying to get across. We absolutely, if we want to create ourselves in an extraordinary version of ourselves, we have to start living in that mindset. We have to start living in that state of being. We have to take command and control of our emotions enough that we can live in the energy of that person that we want to become. Because as we live in the energy of that person and you walk as that person, then you can start to become that person. When you embody your future self, everything changes. So my friend, I just want to tell you that if you've really enjoyed my sharing of these books, these six books, go and check them out in the links below. I truly believe they can be game changers for you this year if you're on a journey to become the greatest version of yourself, to get better every day, and to live an extraordinary life. And if you've enjoyed this and you're going to want to watch this next video that's popping up on the screen, continue to stay inspired and fired up and excited. And no matter what challenges and obstacles you are facing, my friend, just keep going. You can do it. Make it happen.